Hey guys, this is Tim with Little Curl Gunworks, just doing a little product review, success story, I guess you'd call it, on a custom-built 280 Ackley improved hunting rifle that we just finished up for a new client of ours. This is the first build that we've done for this client, and maybe the last. He wanted to build something, kind of do a one-and-done type rifle. And he wanted it for big game. He's a smaller framed guy and didn't want a big magnum, but still wanted something that could do the job on deer and elk. So we discussed different options with him, and we landed on the 280 Ackley. So I'll tell you a little bit about the rifle and some of the services we offer related to custom rifles. So this rifle is built around a Zermatt Arms Origin Action. It's a long action, naturally, to accommodate the 280 Ackley, and it has the 473 standard bolt face. We utilize the HS Precision stock and HS Precision bottom metal and low profile. They call it a low capacity magazine. It's kind of a low profile hunting type magazine. I think it holds four rounds for the 280 Ackley. The stock that it's in is the HS Precision tactical stock, and that happens to be the granite color scheme on it. That comes with, as you can see, a vertical pistol type grip and an elevated comb for better cheek weld and better ability to get a good sight picture through your scope. That stock comes with two swivel studs on the front end. We did replace those swivel studs with the HS Precision Picatinny rail section. That would allow him to attach his bipod of choice to that stock, and that piece of Picatinny rail at the front of it, toward the end of the barrel, or toward the end of the stock rather, has an eyelet for a sling stud, or for a Timona sling. What else? He did select a TriggerTech trigger. I believe he selected the Special, and that is a curved black curved shoe on the trigger. And then we went with he went with a Proof Research 24-inch 9-twist Sendero profile barrel. So the Sendero finishes at about 0.930 inches out there at the muzzle. He did opt to have it threaded, and we discussed options with him for what to use for a muzzle device, and we landed on a muzzle brake that we carry and are promoting. They're made by a guy named Nathan Wright at Muzzle Brakes and More. I think he's out in Idaho, and I think he makes the best brakes money can buy. He's a one-man operation, so that helps keep the overhead low and costs low, and his brakes are extremely reasonable. This happens to be a stainless steel four-port, I think it's called the Little Beast, or the CF Beast 2. Two meaning it's a two-piece, so it's self-timing. He does make them in self-timing and one piece, which would have to be timed by your gunsmith, and it's it also is 0.930, so it matches the barrel flush. So it has a nice fit and finish. And then he did opt to have it Cerakoted graphite black, so the brake matches the barrel really nicely. So naturally the carbon fiber, you wouldn't coat that, but the two parts of the barrel section and the brake and then the action, he also opted to have Cerakoted graphite black, which is the same color that your scope rail and your scope and your rings and things like that would be. That would be the same color. The Zermatt action comes with a 20-minute rail from the factory. We utilized Night Force ultralight rings. The client selected the Burris Veracity PH scope, which is a 6-24 power optic. And I don't know if you know anything about the PH. I don't want to spend a lot of time discussing that, but it's got integral software that you can use an app to basically digitally dial your scope. So it's an interesting product. It took me a little bit of dinking around to kind of get used to it, but I can see how it can be useful for some guys. What else? I think we covered everything on the rifle. So some of the services we offer if you decide to do a full custom build like this is if you choose to, a service we offer is we will sight it in for you, and there's a variety of things that we can do. So we'll sight the rifle in. We also offer a service where we'll do a tall target test for you to figure out how much error is in the tracking mechanism, the vertical tracking mechanism of your scope. Because some people don't know this, but most scopes have a certain amount of error in their turret mechanism, and you can do a test at 100 yards to figure out how much error is in the turret. And as long as it's consistent, you can build that into your ballistic solution and factor in the error, and then it's no longer an issue. So we offer that. We offer a sight-in service, tall target test. We also will do velocity check for you with a lab radar. And that's provided that you select some type of factory ammunition. Obviously, if you are going to hand load for your rifle, these aren't services we can offer, just because we can't test fire with your hand loads. So if you decide to select a factory ammo option, we can source the ammo and get it for you. And typically, depending on what all you want us to do, you know, if it's sighted in at 100 yards, do a tall target test. Then another service we offer is we'll shoot the rifle at long range and see what kind of long range performance we can get, you know, group size, vertical, that sort of thing. And typically, if you want to do all that, we say you're going to commit about 2 boxes of ammo for those services. Now, we usually don't need 2 complete boxes, but I don't want to say I can get it done in one, just in case we have a little more dinking around with each of the tests or to get it sighted in. But in this case, it was fairly straightforward to sight it in, and the group that we have here, this was the first group out of the rifle. I think this was shots 4, 5, and 6. So we fired it once to check. Just to test fire it for safety to make sure that that worked, and then I think it took me 3 rounds to get it sighted in, or 2 rounds to get it, 3 rounds to get it sighted in, and then this was rounds 4, 5, and 6, or 5, 6, and 7, something like that. So shot a half inch group at 100 yards. Now that's not something we necessarily guarantee. This is just how this one worked out. He selected good components and good ammunition. He went with Hornady Precision Hunter 162 grain ELDX, and again, this was a 24 inch proof barrel, and his velocity average for this round was right at 2890 feet a second, which is a pretty serious performance considering the bullet he's using, that 162 ELDX. It's a really high BC bullet. I would call it a medium game bullet. I personally wouldn't use it for elk. Just because I don't think it's constructed heavily enough, but it's certainly adequate for mule deer, whitetail, antelope, things like that. Basically, mule deer on down, 300, 350 pound critters on down. And with that kind of performance, if you're in mule deer country, let's say you're at about 5,000 feet out west, this round still retains 2,000 feet per second of velocity and 1,440 foot-pounds of energy at 950 yards. Now, I'm not necessarily condoning shooting that far. For me personally, I try to set a boundary with velocity, energy, and also time of flight. And for me, anything over 1 second time of flight is too long. So this round travels 820 yards in that 1 second limit. So for me, this rifle would be an 820 and in setup. And at 820 in mule deer country, it still has 2,113 feet per second and just over 1,600 foot-pounds of energy, which is more than enough for any mule deer walking the earth. So, tested at a few different ranges, so I hit some steel and worked my way out to our 640-yard target. And I'm guessing with all the videos I've done, a lot of guys are wondering why 640 yards. Well, the private farm that we shoot at, the landowner, where he has his crops and the way he rotates his crops, 640 yards just happens to be the distance where I can set up a permanent target that I never have to move and never have to take down, and it's not in his way for any of his farming activities. So he kind of lets me sprinkle targets here and there, but 640 is a good medium range, where that should probably be the outer limit of most people's long range hunting activities. And it's where I can set up a target and never have to take it down. So that's why we use 640, not because it holds any other significance other than that. It's just where I'm able to set it up and not have to pull it down every time I go out to the farm to shoot. So at 640 yards, shot a few different groups. This one, with the wind conditions that day, this happened to be the smallest group that I shot. It was 3 3/4 inches, again, at 640 yards. And I think it had about 2 inches of vertical, maybe just over 2 to 2.5 inches of vertical, which is really good. That's really respectable for factory ammunition. Even hand loads, that would be considered pretty good. So it's about a third minute of angle of vertical, which is really, really good. So I'd say this is perfectly adequate long-range ammo. And again, it's factory ammo, so the rifle performed really well. Again, this isn't a guarantee of performance. This is just a success story. I wanted to show you guys how these rifles can shoot when you select good components and do everything, you know, get everything put together well. And obviously our gunsmith, Dale Hegstrom, he makes a fantastic rifle. So most customers we build a rifle for, they end up boomeranging back and wanting another one built at some point. So usually once we build a rifle for somebody, they're a customer for life. So this one turned out really well. So I just wanted to review that with you guys. If there's any questions you have about it, feel free to give us a call or put a line down in the comments. I'll answer any questions you might have about it. But that's all I have for now. Just wanted to show you guys that. This one turned out really good. Customer was super happy, obviously. And yeah, so obviously we can make a custom rifle in just about any cartridge you can think of. This one, you know, if we have the reamer for it. Otherwise, if we can source a reamer, we will. But this is a good lightweight package. Oh, I didn't talk about that. So this rifle came in right at 10 pounds, 8 ounces. And to me, that is kind of the sweet spot of what you want for a long range hunting rifle. If you start getting lighter than that, the rifle just gets really hard to drive and hard to shoot accurately and consistently. And if you get lighter than that too, the rifle jumps around a lot, so it's hard to spot your trace and see where your impacts are going. You know, a lot of guys obsess about getting a super light rifle, and I can tell you they're be careful what you wish for. You're like, okay, I want a 7-pound rifle or an 8-pound rifle. Well, those rifles, they're not very easy to shoot, not accurately. And they're really hard to see. Once that thing goes off, even with a muzzle brake, it's hard to see where the round goes. So unless you're hunting with a spotter, you're not going to be able to spot your own impact. So for me, depending on cartridge and recoil and what brake we select and things like that, I feel like 9.5 to even all the way up to 12 pounds is kind of where you want to be. You know, if you have a big magnum, I'd say you want to be over 11 for sure, just so the rifle is drivable and easy to control. But this one came in, I think, at about 10 pounds 8 ounces without the bipod. So I feel like that's a really good weight for this type of setup, and the rifle was very controllable and easy to shoot, and it was a pleasure to shoot. So that's all we have for this one. I guess if you have any questions, again, hit us up in the comments or give us a call. Or if there's anything you're considering building and you just have questions, I'd be happy to answer those for you. And you can see what else we have going on at littlecrowgunworks.com. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the next one.